Marjorie Greene just can't understand why people in DC treat her as if she's some kind of a crazy person. Right? I mean, Marjorie Greene? Crazy? Why is she crazy? Who would think she's crazy? Before we even get into this, I just have to show you this. This was shared by Farron Cousins. This is Marjorie Greene's high school picture. She 100% called cops on house parties in high school because she wasn't invited. Absolutely. Look at this. Look at this. Does this not scream Karen energy? She's got the turtleneck with the necklace over the turtleneck. Oh, you know she's a Karen. So she was on Alex Jones talking about how she doesn't really like that people in DC treat her as if she's crazy. And she's saying all of this, mind you, on InfoWars, the show where they unironically claim that there is a pedophile ring on Mars and also that there are human hybrids, human-animal hybrids, being kept in prisons in the United States. And also there's fish people, according to Alex Jones. So she's on this show, which is a crazy show, and she's like, hey, I'm tired of people saying that I'm crazy. So let's go ahead and watch.
And I'm just a regular person. I've never been in politics before. And going to Washington, the most disturbing thing that I have found is that the people in Washington, it's like a little bubble. And it's this tiny little world. And if you really look at it, it's a small percentage of people, but they truly look down on the rest of America. And they think that everything they think in their little bubble and what they want for our country is the most important thing. But they look down on the common American man and woman, and they just don't care. They're so disconnected.
So what she's saying is absolutely correct here, but it also applies to her. It's funny that she thinks that this analysis isn't also attributed to her. As an outsider who's not a member of Congress, the same can be said about you. You're not fighting for anything that we need. She talks about some of these issues. Once in a while, she'll say the words working class together, but she has no fucking policies. Look at this. This is from her website. I'm a conservative wife, mother, and businesswoman who 100% stands with President Trump and against the left-wing socialists who want to wreck our country. Now, when she had, I don't know if this is current or whatnot, but when she had her platform, it was basically stop socialism. Stop socialism is not a policy. What specific policy prescriptions are you going to institute to stop socialism? Because we live in a neoliberal hellhole. I mean, we are a late-stage capitalist society, so to think that socialism is actually a threat to capitalism in 2022, you have to be delusional. You have to be, dare I say, crazy. But according to her, it's absurd to think that she's crazy. The way that people look at her as if she's crazy, insane.
They don't even care about kids wearing masks. They don't care about our border with fentanyl pouring across.
I don't care about kids wearing masks. That's not an issue. Who gives a shit?
Killing young people and being the number one cause of death, not COVID.
Yeah, I actually do care about drug overdoses. So, Marjorie, will you join me in calling for the decriminalization of all drugs? Will you do that? No, you're not going to do that. You like to complain, but you don't have any policy prescriptions. No far right wingers do, because right wingers are inherently neoliberal. So they think that private solutions are the perfect response to public problems. The problem is that they got everything that they wanted. They won. The capitalists won. And we're more fucked up than ever before as a country and as a world. So now they don't know what to say. You know, before it was, oh no, privatize. We need, you know, less government, less regulations. And they got that. So now the problems are worse than ever. And they're like, this is bad, but I don't know what to say. I don't know what to do about it.
19. And it just bothers me so much. They treat me as if I'm some kind of crazy person or like I have three horns coming out of my head.
I mean, yeah. Because you're crazy as shit. I mean, Republicans are to the point where they're nearly shitting their pants publicly and spitting on people. Trump hissed at people, right? So it's like, I don't understand why she's so perplexed as to why people view her as a weirdo. Before you were elected to Congress, you were screaming into the mail slot at AOC. How many people have had to change offices? I know Cory Bush, I think, I could be wrong, but another member of Congress had to change offices because you were harassing them. That's why they look at you like you're crazy. And most people in DC, I don't think that they're normal per se, right? But they're certainly more normal than you. I don't know how to explain your behavior. It almost feels ableist to criticize you. You're so fucking stupid.
But what they don't understand is they're the ones that are crazy, and they're the ones that are so disconnected.
Well, that's
they're the ones that are crazy, not me. Alex Jones, believer in fish people, care to weigh in?
Gaslighting that they're engaged in. I mean, if you look at it, the trends worldwide are
look at all of this. Jesus Christ. Dude, get a laptop. You have a whole book on your fucking desk. And none of this is real information. None of this is data or statistics. What the fuck are you looking at? Goddamn.
Populism and the people, not even about conservative or liberal. And deep down, they know that. They're trying to gaslight us. At least the controllers at the top are. But I think the average leftist, I agree with you, actually does think you've got five heads or I've got six heads. And that they actually believe their own BS.
You believe in fish people. Alex Jones, you believe in fish people. Let me show you all what I'm talking about here. Because as they discuss how they're the normal ones, let me find this here. Give me one second. I've got to show you all this if you haven't seen it yet.
I was told by a genetic engineer about a project they were on in England once, and I never told the story on air because it's so fantastical. Oh, God. They had in tanks people with gills, and they were little babies, and they were in there just gulping, clawing at the sides. You see a turtle at the zoo, and it wants out, and you feel for it. They got humanoids crossed with fish and stuff. I mean, we are screwed, people. I mean, do you understand that? And I know I keep obsessing because it's in the news what they're doing now. They don't show it to you. They just go, yeah, gestating on farms or embryos of humans growing in animals. No, it's beyond that. They take them out. They keep them alive. And notice they go, the only law is you don't put it in a real human woman. And don't worry, these creatures don't have any rights because they're not human and they're not animal. They're in that phantom zone. They're in that fifth dimension of the Twilight Zone. And they're just opening the gates of hell. And I just can't sit here and go along with all the pomps and the stupid Hollywood people and everyone preening and driving their $200,000 cars and getting off on being on TV. I don't even hardly watch when I'm on television. I hate it. I hate this whole culture. I hate the whole thing. It means nothing to me. It's all fake. It's all a facade. And behind it are mad scientists in the Hall of the Mountain King just doing God knows what, super weapons, antimatter bombs, black holes, huge cyclotrons, splicing every plant and animal on the known face of the earth. And it's the most satanic rituals you can imagine. Those are satanic rituals. Detonating hundreds of high-powered hydrogen bombs in the 1960s in the upper atmosphere to see if they could detonate the Earth's atmosphere and blow holes in the Van Allen radiation belt is so satanic. Splicing little babies with fish is satanic. Putting prions and all this garbage in our food is satanic. You think real Satanists go and just sit there and have sex with some hot chick on a black altar? That's how they get the low-level people in. Real Satanism is about murdering this planet. And all you stinking Satanists are nothing but cowards that have tried to join this system. You have no idea what Lucifer's got in store with you. You scum. You're going to be torn limb from limb slowly. You're going to beg. Your deaths are going to be slow. Know that, scum. The gulping humanoids in their tanks, scrabbling at the side with human horror in their eyes.
And that's not taking into account him claiming that there are pedophile rings or one big ring on Mars. They take children to Mars and, yeah, they abuse them.